When I first took this studio space, it was kind of a rough neighborhood. It was just me and three drunks around the corner. And now it's yoga pants and coffee cups. I guess you could say it's gentrified. There's a cafe, a food hall just down the road. And suddenly that's changed everything. And that's fine. But the truth is, when I walk through my door and I'm here in this space, I'm not in any place. I don't think about geographically where I am. I like to make my own frames for these works. I don't particularly like a mass-produced frame or a frame shop frame. I find that there's a coldness to that. These are a bit wonky. I make them by myself and I spill a little glue here and there. The corners don't come together perfectly. The wood is totally unfinished and will yellow. There's a kind of built-in patina to it. And I think that that's the right framing solution for paintings like this that so clearly show the hand of the artist who made them. I'm totally alone here, and I do everything myself. I stretch my own canvas. I prime the canvas myself. I gesso, I sand. Nothing about it is perfect. I think you can see that it isn't something you just go and buy. And the preparation of the surface for paintings, such as these oils that I'm doing now, is really interesting because there are many ways to prepare a surface. You can simply paint on the primed canvas the way it comes out of a roll. And that's fine, and you get the color of this linen, for example, that I'm using, this beautiful beige gray. And this can come through, and it's interesting to me to work with that. Sometimes I look at the work that I'm doing now, and I very much like what I see. But then I go back to something I did a year ago, and I ask myself if I've really gone anywhere at all. Have I improved? Am I painting in a better way? Is the quality better now than it was a year ago? Or have I lost something that I had in more of a naive approach to doing these things, to painting? Painting is a constant decision-making process. Every time you face a blank canvas, you're facing a series of decisions that have to be made. And so you choose to go down this path as opposed to that path. And I think that that's what makes art successful for me. When you look at a painting and you feel that the artist has made all the right decisions, and that destination of a painting was a find. It is a struggle making art. I throw a lot away. There are a lot of totally failed paintings that find themselves shredded and in the garbage. But somehow it doesn't discourage me. I never seem to get tired of this struggle. Of the effort. I do think about where these works stand, say, in terms of contemporary art. I think that there are people who might even be used to looking at quite a lot of new art, who would look at these and ask themselves, is this contemporary art? And I'm okay with that. I don't know if these speak to the moment or the time in which we live. I suppose I'm looking for freedom from temporality. I know I'll never achieve that, but I can point myself in that direction, can't I?